Homework 4.1, number 2, is an application of the area under a curve. Let's take a look at the question. A concert promoter sells X tickets and has a marginal revenue function given by this function here, where R prime of X is in dollars per ticket, and X is the number of tickets sold. And the question is, we want to find the total revenue from the sale of the first 350 tickets. So in order to find the total revenue from the marginal revenue, we have to find the area under this curve on the interval from 0 to 350, and that will result in the total revenue. Let's start by taking a look at the graph of this derivative function. You see, I've already typed it into y1, and the big thing about getting the graph is to adjust the window so you get a nice picture. And so the first thing we should notice is that the x values will range from 0 to 350. Now, to figure out what the y values should be on the y-axis, we might want to use the table. If I press second graph, I can see that when x is 0, y is negative 730, and when x is 350, y is negative 30. These values must be within our y minimum and y maximum. So what I did is I let x start at 0 and go to 350 by tens, and then I set the y minimum to negative 750 and the y max to positive 60. I made this positive because I wanted to make sure that I saw the x-axis. And the result is this graph. So what we want to do is find the area bounded by the function and the x-axis, which looks like a triangle. Remember, the y value right here was negative 30, so in fact it's a trapezoid where the two parallel bases are here and here, and notice this base is very small. Let's go ahead and paste this on the next slide and do our work. Let's label some key values here. This is the point 0, 0. This would be the point 0, negative 730, which we just saw from the table. This point here would be 350, 0. And this point here is 350, negative 30. And again, our goal is to find the area of this trapezoid, which represents the total revenue from the sale of the first 350 tickets. So again, be careful, it's not a triangle, it is a trapezoid. This segment here is very short, but it is one of the parallel bases for the trapezoid. Here's the area formula for our trapezoid. Let's see if we can fill it out. We have 1/2 times base 1 plus base 2. Let's call this base 1. Well, base 1 would be f of 0, or negative 730. And we do have to take the sign with it, even though we do think of a length as being positive in most cases. Plus, over here we would have base 2. Well, base 2 would be f of 350, which would return a value of negative 30. And then times the height. Now, this trapezoid is turned on its side. This here would be the height, which has a length of positive 350. So to find our area here, or think of it as signed area, we'd have 1/2 times negative 760 times 350, which equals negative 133,000. And that represents the loss in revenue from the sale of the first 350 tickets. So I wanted to show this example because this is the first one we've seen where the function is below the x-axis, which will result in an area being negative, which just means that in this case we have a total loss in revenue. I hope you found this explanation helpful. Thank you.